Hi guys, I'm just gonna do a review for my YouTube channel. I have some spare time today, so I thought as it's raining out, I'll make a quick video. So I'm gonna do it on loafers. These are Christian Louboutins and these are Tom Fords. It's quite a price difference and there's quite a different image too. So I'd say you need one brown pair and you need one black pair in life. The Christian Louboutins, they're sexy. They're a sexy shoe and they work good for the right suit, the right jewelry. And then these ones, these are actually more sexy. Most people don't know that, man. These are 3 times the price as those. Everyone thinks that's the best. It's not. It might be. This is what I like. Let me put it that way. And this one, I can put on shorts and go for a bike ride in these. Man, I do it all the time. Nobody knows. They just think that they're, whatever, cheap loafers, but they feel good. They did look really nice when they were brand new. They've lost their shine. I don't even know where you get a shoe shining equipment anymore. Man, that's like, I don't know the leather. I know it's calfskin, but I would imagine it's some sort of shell cordovan, I think. They do that on watch straps too. This leather, I would imagine it's not as good. This part's like fabric. And then that is like a suede. They hold up pretty good. On the bottom, you're gonna get your typical Christian Louboutin, made in Italy, 41 and a half. I never did put on the special sole. A lot of people go right out of the store and they put on these special soles, making them last longer. I never did. I was like, whatever. Because the reason is you put your foot up and you know somebody's gonna look. And it's kind of cool. It's a show-off thing. The shoe itself, both are really nice. This one, let me show you the bottom of this one. So this is going to be just a leather. This is kind of like a cowboy boot, man. And that's my nature. I was a rodeo star for a while. Anyways, now when I was in the store, actually, this is a shout-out to Tom Ford. They put on the shelf a shoe that the paint was smeared along here. Now, I'm actually missing part of my finger there, but I'll only use my nice finger. This paint, I picked it up on the shelf of this store. I'm like, oh, that's a sexy shoe. All right. And I was like, man, they messed it up. And the store didn't even catch it. Now, when you're spending this kind of money, you're going to look at it at least for a few minutes and see if it's what you want. And these ones, the store ordered, Holt Renfrew in Vancouver ordered this shoe for me. There's a fuzz on there. And they shipped it. I think they shipped it right to my house. It's a size 8. They're about the same. Now, when you get a good quality shoe, the sizing is pretty similar. Now, when you go into Walmart and you're buying whatever jumpers, shoes, or whatever, Reeboks or something, they're always going to fluctuate. But my cowboy boots and my loafers and whatever lace-ups I have, Oxfords, they're always around size 8. Now this shoe, this is what they call Alcatan Twisted Loafer. So a penny loafer, you could stick in pennies, right? It's all based off of old-fashioned times. I'm not a pro. If you really want to know, you should look at another video. I don't know enough about it, but it's sticking coins. Now this one's a twisted. Nobody sticks coins in anymore. And then they got the bit one, right? Your bit loafer, and then the other. They got all sorts of kinds. It's all old Western stuff. Look at that stitching there, man. Wow, it's worn out. And then on the sides too, it's a little worn out, a little bit beat up. I wear them all the time. So what they do on this shoe, you see how you don't see the stitching here on this edge? I'll use my nice finger again. On this edge, you don't see the stitching because they go in with a knife and they slit right down in the side here. And you can kind of see where the slit mark was. Oh, well, there you see it. Right that lip. Then they slit it, they stitch it through, and then they reseal it. And I have had no problems at all. And I wear these all the time. just put them on, blue jeans, like bike rides, flip-flops, and these basically go perfect hand in hand. Now these ones I don't wear very often. They're kind of a show-off shoe. It's almost too much. It's too much of a heat score. And the truth is, like I said before, this is 1/3 of the shoe of this. In maybe not quality, I wouldn't go as far as quality. I would just say in the way you feel. This is like a trick. I love it. Christian Louboutins, I highly, highly recommend them. But if you really want to go the extra mile, you don't want to get something that's all leather, that's got like a, you know, a proper, it's got like a leather heel on it. Like it's like a cowboy boot, like I said. Now they both do. You know, when you get good shoes, you're going to get all leather. You're going to get these kind of rivets. These metal rivets all over the place. I don't know if it's the actual best wearing shoe. I've seen some other companies, some custom made stuff that probably wears a lot better if you want long-term, you know, footwear, I guess. You know, if you want to get 5 or 6 years out of it daily. I don't wear these daily. I wear them maybe three to four or five times a week, max. I wear them on the rain and everything, and they seem to hold up, go dancing in them, spinning around on their floor or whatever. It doesn't matter. Inside, well, I don't wear socks. They look like they've been worn for a year, right? That's kind of what you get. There's another one. That's kind of what you're going to get inside. It's all leather. It's really nice. Just your foot slides right into it. This one, I actually had, looks like I put in an insole on this one. And it's probably a mistake, to tell you the truth. Maybe if it was a little more worn out, like this one, eventually I'll have to do the same thing when it wears out. But it tends to change the feel of the shoe. So now loafers, I'll tell you one thing. This you need to hear if you buy these kind of shoes. You gotta get them fitting your feet, and they should be kind of uncomfortable. Now, when I was walking around the lake in these, I could wear them for not very long. I could never dance in them very long, either or. But over time, if you just keep enduring on it, you will find that they just start fitting like a glove. They start molding. The outside, my feet are a little wider, I think, than most people, so I don't believe they have these in a triple E. Oh, look, I put my name on this one. So nobody steals my shoe. I am getting my microphone next week, so I ordered one, so hopefully it's going to cut out all this extra wind noise. What's the inside look on this shoe? So it's a Christian Louboutin, man. That's a, like I said, a sexy, sexy shoe. Oh yeah, you want to steal some hearts, steal some kisses too, you get that one. If you want to just feel like the coolest guy around town, man, you want to wear your clogs. You wear the Twisted Elk Tan loafer. I might be saying it wrong, but I know what it is. Let's see the back. Let's just compare the back between these two Tom Fords and Christian Louboutin. So, you know, I'm getting a bit of a close-up now. This one is not symmetrical. This is symmetrical. And this, let's see if the other one's like that too. Okay, so they're not. They're not designed. That's the beautiful thing about fashion. The angle here is less than the angle here. We call that a concave radius. This is smaller. And these are two parallel lines. The heel is probably, it's your standard, whatever, 1 inch maybe. It's 1 inch, I'd say. Pretty standard, give or take an eighth of an inch. Not going to be a deal breaker anyway. You definitely want to have good posture. You don't want to be wearing a flat shoe, too flat of a shoe, you know, if you're going to be walking around all day, because it straightens out your back. So I think they're just designed that way. They're already made that way. We got on the inside. Let's see what this is. Probably, now I know this shoe is like last year's model. They stopped making these models, otherwise it wouldn't be designer stuff if they kept running them year after year. But it looks like I've got a model number in here, and this, the width, you see that, it's a D J. Can you see? Oh man, that's, I don't want to make a bad video. 11031D, and then there's another something here. One. Let's see what that one is. Let's just see this. I don't know, man. That feels like a... That skin right there is... That's like your... It's not as good. I know it's not as good, man. Like I said, this is good. This patina. Look at the wrinkles. Look at those, man. My brother, I was at the store with him last week, and when you stepped like this, it was a perfect wrinkle like this. And I was like, man, that shoe's not gonna be good long term. You want multiples. Look at that, man. Just like, oh, look at that. I've already had these. I've been wearing them probably close to 2 years now. I've had these ones even longer. I bought these ones right when the pandemic started. I thought it was gonna be over soon, man. Whatever. Anyways, it worked out good for me. That's the video I wanted to make. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Shoes. Next, I'll do... That's it. I have 18 subscribers. Thank you very much. Have a good day.